My Life in Portugal. Expectations, Prices, Bureaucracy and House Tour. Romanas mūsų NFKRZ. Kaip jums sekas Portugalijoje gyventi? Pabėgėliui.
Sirius boy Roman, your favorite neighborhood Russian and welcome
Rusijos
to beautiful in Portugal. Yes guys, today I finally once again went outside to film a video for you guys. Amazing, incredible, smash like. I'm actually touching grass. Touching water in fact, you guys.
Oh wow, Lopas.
It's great. I don't know why I just did that. Anyway, here we are in a pretty cool place. Park das Nações. I think that's how it's pronounced. It's called Park of Nations.
It's
sort of a new area, new neighborhood here that was built around like the end of the 90s in Portugal. It's got a bunch of cool stuff.
Yra Lietuvos vėliava čia?
And also, I just
wanted
to show you this place because I think this is the only place probably in the entirety of like the European Union that still flies a Russian flag. So this right here, you know, has flags of tons of nations. So yes, every single country here has like its own map with the flag and everything. And some countries, which are controversial, of course, they are missing. Of course, guys, a big one currently is Israel. As you can see, guys, what we have here is this. Russia, of course, being a pretty controversial country right now, is also it's been vandalized a little bit, let's put it that way. Palestine. Portugal, of course, great. Put it that way. Palestine.
Palestina. Oh, nuostabi teritorija ir vėliava jos. Ir tai yra, okay, aha. Aha, matosi, kur jų žemės yra, okay, makes sense.
Portugal, of course, greatest country in the world. Швецию подрали всю. Who's got beef with Sweden, dude? They created meatballs in IKEA. Like, what is going on here? And there it is. The Russian flag, once again. It's probably not, but I want to claim that this is the only
Kas
place in Europe that still has the Russian flag out in the open. Here's a bunch of stuff that I can't show on my channel.
A bunch of Putin insults.
Because they will literally jail me if I show the slogans that are written on the this thing here that's supposed to have the map of Russia. So, very interesting, but the reason why I brought you guys out here today is because today I decided to go out and talk about my experience so far living in Portugal. I've been here about 3 months now, so I decided that it's gonna be fun to talk about it with you guys and also give you a tour of a little bit of a beautiful Lisbon. I mean, check this out, guys. Isn't this amazing? Life is great. Ukraine.
Kada Portugalijos rinkimai? When are the next Portugal elections? 26 metais bus prezidento rinkimai, tai už poros metų. O šiais metais buvo. To jų parlamento, įgės, šiais metais buvo. Tarsi aš kažką čia dabar žinočiau. Luis Montenegro laimėjo su partija privalomų sveikatos draudimų. Ir gavo netgi daugiau vietų PSD partijai. Čia yra Partido Social Democrata. Turbūt gerai perskaičiojo, manau gerai. EPP Europos parlamente, okay. Praleidom rinkimus, tik už 4 metų bus. Nu jo, šiemet 24, tiek kaip ten sakė, Europos rinkimų metai, tipo daug kur.
And somebody has written, I want to go home on it, which is yeah, it's a little sad. And also some other flags
that I want
to go home. It's amazing, life is great. Ukraine,
Ukraine.
And somebody has written, I want to go home on it, which is yeah, it's a little sad. And also some other flags that show us when this entire area was built, essentially, is you can actually still, for example, see Yugoslavia here. This is not the OG Yugoslavia, right? The big-ass one. But this is Serbian Montenegro, essentially, right? They got renamed into that later. But yes, guys, even Yugoslavia is still alive in our hearts here in Lisbon, Portugal. So essentially this entire area here, this Park of Nations, it's built around the embankment. So you got a beautiful view and also you see there's a cable cars going back and forth, which we will actually go on probably. But yes, basically so far, the first thing I want to talk about regards my expectations and impressions of Portugal is actually the weather, which actually turned out to be not as hot as I imagined. Well, at least currently, because right now we're actually filming this video, it's like 21 Celsius. This summer, supposedly, at least the start of the summer in Portugal is not as hot as it usually is. And I've already gotten a couple of jokes from local Portuguese people telling me that I brought Russian cold here to Portugal or whatever. But I wouldn't exactly describe this as Russian cold right now. As you can see, I'm clearly breaking a sweat, but I'm also like the most palest Siberian like motherfucker of all time.
Žinokit, nenoriu nieko sakyti, bet aš irgi įdegiau iš tikro, blėt, nes saulė biškį ridiculous čia buvo keletą dienų, bet biškį, tai, bet nesmarkiai, viskas gerai, nesmarkiai, žodžiu, bet actually, biškį įdegiau.
So I really feel like I'm basically, you know, I'm boiling, but this isn't, you know, it's gonna get a lot worse. But yes, on a serious note, I do love the weather here. I mean, the sun, the water. Portugal is definitely one of those places in which you can actually go outside and feel better about yourself because the outside looks beautiful. Quite different to when you live in a commie block of Cidades in the middle of fucking dog shit winter. It's super enjoyable. Every single time you go outside here, it's a breeze. And also, I just love the fact that there's always so many people out. You see, it's a Tuesday right now, and this is not even the most popular.
Aš žinau, bet iš tikro, kaip pagalvojus, tas pasakymas išeik į lauką, tipo, pasivaikščiok ar dar kažką. Nu, tipo, šiaip tiesiog išeit. Nu jo, iš tikro, žmogui, nu ten jam sunku, žinai, emociškai kažkas ar dar kažką. Jo, yra smagu išeini, nežinau, į parką. Parkas tvarkytas, ten, žalia, nežinau, nu, tipo, cool. Bet, ble, kai išeini, va, rimtai į rajoną, ir ten viskas nešvarų purvas, žinai, lempus sudaužytos. Nu, tipo, tai kažin, ar tau labai ten nuotaika pakels ar kažką. Tai jo, galima tik pasidžiaugti, kad Lietuvoje, nu, bent jau Kaune, patvarkyti. Ir parkai, ir viską dėl išeisi lauką, jo, bus gan gražu ir tvarkinga, ir tipo, kur benueisi čia. Nebent jau visai užkampi kažkokio rajono gal eisi ten, bet jau reikia ieškoti specifiškai tokio. Seliai, užeisi kažkokį tarp namų kiemą, sutvarkyta mokykla, kiemelis sutvarkytas, sutvarkyta, tiesiog, jo, Lietuva. Karius už Trumpą ar Biden, nemačiau debatų reakto, tu ko mes klausiu, už ką aš balsuočiau, ar debatų to, kas laimėjo ten, ar kaip. Aš jeigu galėčiau balsuoti, balsuočiau už Trumpą. Tai už Bideną, Jėzau, už Bideną. Trumpas debatuose pasirodė, turiu omeny, literally pasirodė kaip geresnis, bet jis klausiais, ką sakė, viskai pralošė vienareikšmiškai. Problema tik, kad Bidenas pasirodė tipo kaip silpnesnis, bet ką sakė, tai ten net nebuvo ką vartyti, jis Trumpą suvartė visiškai. Bet jo, aš nežinau, ko tu būtent klausi. O aš tai balsuočiau vien dėl to, kad jis jau geresnis politikas, daug efektyvesnis ir lyderis ir politikas, daugiau savo agendos pasiekė, padarė ir Lietuvos interesams daug geriau atitinka, tai jo, I don't know.
It's super enjoyable. Every single time you go outside here, it's a breeze. And also, I just love the fact that there's always so many people out. You see, it's a Tuesday right now, and this is not even the most popular location in the city, not super central. There's so many people out just chilling, eating, smoking weed, I don't fucking know, drinking beers, walking with their kids. There's always somebody like playing football or something. Essentially, it feels like every day is sort of like a celebration in a weird way. And there's always something going on. That's also one thing I really, really enjoy. A ton of events, concerts and everything. And I just, you know, for example, I'm going to be going to a Travis Scott concert, like right there, in that arena right there. Very excited, guys. Hope I don't get trampled. But yeah, you know, I don't usually get to see these cool artists that I like in Russia or, you know, just Eastern Europe in general. Events and concerts actually come here. So it's nice to feel like a part of a world community in a sense for one time in my life.
Portugalia, Tugal population. 10,4 milijono. Okay, 3 kartus didesnė, nu, tarkim, 4, 3 kartus didesnė. A, nu, 3,5, tarkim.
You know what I mean?
Jo, Lisabona, jo, lygtais. Kiek Lisbon population, Lisbon, 500 tūkstančių, okay.
One thing that I personally really enjoy about Lisbon overall is just that it's like so open. There's so many open spaces and parks which are just great to hang out in. Like first of all, you know, we gotta talk about like bike lanes and stuff like that. That kind of infrastructure. It's Europe. It's here, you know. But also just in general, it's so open and it's so like free. And I don't know how to put it any other way because when I lived in Georgia, in Tbilisi, no hate on Tbilisi, it's a great city. It's got its own vibe. It's awesome. But it is definitely a city that is way more crammed together because it's located essentially in the middle of a valley surrounded by mountains and hills. It almost feels like everybody's sort of crammed in, like, sardines in that kind of... Here, though, the city doesn't seem that big, but there's so much open space and just, like, I don't know. You're just free to fucking dick around and be yourself. And that's exactly what I do all day now.
Įdomu, kiek žmogus psichologijai turi tos vat atviros erdvės, kad nėra viskas visą laiką suspausta, kad gali išėti kokią aikštę ir ten bus, žinai, plati daug vietos. Huh. Do large open spaces in cities Green spaces šia man labiau randa. Simply having access to green spaces in cities can do wonders for our stress levels and concentration at work. Ja, bet čia green spaces. Aš nežinau, ar tiesiog tokios atviros erdvės kaip aikštės ten visokios, ar jos turi kažkokio. Kad žalios, tai jo, žalia, tą jau žinau, kad tipo ilgą laiką tyrė, jo, bet čia tik... Ekonomik čia. Physical mental community. Man įdomu, šiaip atviros erdvės.
Because I have no sense or purpose in life. But no, it's great. It's great. Ахуеть, типа. However, I still do not go outside and don't film videos outside because I just stay depressed inside of my room. That being said though, guys, I've done a lot of work on my apartment here in Lisbon, behind the scenes obviously, so how about we teleport right to my apartment and I give you guys a beautiful room tour. Hey there guys, welcome to my crib. Yes. Now usually guys, before, I showed you my entire apartment as a part of an apartment tour, but now I'm an old man and I have some boundaries. So instead I'm gonna only show you guys the studio. This is where the magic happens, this is where I sit and record my videos, my camera is right there. Everything I have as far as tech goes was pretty much bought in Russia and then I shipped it to Georgia and then I shipped it from Georgia to Portugal. It was a whole ordeal, you know. My desk, I do have a standing desk, but I really don't use the function, maybe
what?
I should. MF Doom, not a vinyl actually, this is just a print.
Kas čia, nach, judomas stalas, ar jūs išprotėjot?
Really don't use...
Kas taip daro? Kas judina stalą? Judamas. Tu padarai stalą, jo nejudini, pripranti ir tada nejudini. Nes jeigu pajudinsi stalą centimetrai viršų, nebepataikysi galvą counterį ir panašiai, nes biškai taip reikės aimint. Wow.
Is the function? Maybe I should. MF Doom, not a...
Pala, o kom nugarai gerai? Ai, gali atsistojęs dirbti? Oh. Nu, I guess, jo, tai jeigu reikia kažką, gali atsistojęs, tarkim, pabūti.
Vinyl, actually, this is just a printed picture that's framed. This...
Yra pliusų, bet aš aišku, labiau jokavau, nes, nu... Counteriai ten ir panašiai žmonės esporte priprasdavo prie vieno stalo, prie vieno, nu, kilimėlio ir panašiai ir negalėdavo kitur funkcionuoti. Tai ten nuvažiuoja į laną, o ten stalai, pavyzdžiui, nu, 5 centimetrų žemiau ir jie nebepataiko. Žmonės nebepataiko, nes, nu, ranka pripranta, nu, pavyzdžiui, kaip ranka laikai ant stalo, žinai, ir kur tavo remiasi ar nesiremia, pavyzdžiui, kokios kėdės yra, ar atsiremia ranka ar ne. Nes jeigu tu eimini, tai... daro skirtumą, nu, kaip tu aiminsi, žinai, čia aš labiau tą šitą sakiau, kad tipo tai, ką darydavo jo, tai kad pripranta prie vieno ir viskas, ir dangos ten vienos ir visko, o ši čia reguliuoti, tai tu tipo netyčia, žinai, centimetrą pajunsi ir nebepataikas ir panašiai, bet jo. Istorija Vilniaus centrinė gatvė, open ir turi good amount of space, kai neturim laisvės alėje projektuoti caro 19 amžiai ir miesto centrą yra crammed. Pas mūsų miesto centras yra kremt Kaune? Kaip tik belink kiek erdvės. Nu, visa Laisvės alėja realiai yra gan daug vietos. Ir tada Rotušė yra didelė plati aikštė, tipo. Tada už Rotušės yra tas visas santakos, ten didelės, nu, plačios erdvės. What? Aš skaičiu Vilnius, kaip tik senamiesis daug labiau kremt. Bet ne, nu, ten irgi yra ir parkai, ir erdvės tokios, ir tada katedros taip. Ne, nesakyčiau, bet sakyčiau gal... Huh. Kad Kaunas kremt, aš nesu net girdėjęs tokio kremt. Tikrai nesakyčiau. Gatvė siauros Vilniaus... Plak, kokia gatvė? Kokią mes gatvę lyginam? Su kokia Vilniaus gatvė? Ar ką tu lygini?
Maybe I should. MF Doom, not a vinyl actually, this is just a not printed sure. picture that's framed. This hat that was gifted to me by Gatsu, actually. This here is an old map of Europe, in Portuguese, old Portuguese at that too. And you even have my region of Russia here, the Chelyabinsk region. Funnily enough, my city of Chelyabinsk is not even on this map. But I did put this little pin here, saying Chelyabinsk Oblast. This is actually something I got at a flea market in St. Petersburg when I did that video with Bolden Bankrupt, when we went to Shop for Some Vintages and he picked out this pin, I think. And I just have it here where my heart is. Chelyabinsk, obviously. One thing I got recently that made my setup way more professional is I got some foam. The echo in this room in this apartment was absolutely awful, so having these foam panels here actually makes the audio sound decent, and I am now officially a professional YouTuber. I've only bought fucking foam panels on like year 10 of my YouTube career, or whatever it is.
Nice.
Worst YouTuber, guys. Worst YouTuber.
Aš visada dabar neturiu foamo.
And now get the fuck out of my room.
Aš visada dar neturiu to visų tų foamų, kur garsą sugeria, bet pas mane audio kokybė blogera tikrai ne dėl to, kad foamo kambarį nėra to, nes pas nai yra, kur tas garsas susigeria pilna visokios stuff ir panašiai, tiesiog settingai, pač audio, fuck that shit, šetono sugalvoto atsakau. What the fuck?
And also guys, once again,
Fontana
another
shit?
Beautiful oh. feature of European infrastructure, drinking fountains, hell yes. I would like to...
What? Ai, šitas, aš... Sako, drinking fountains. Aš galvoju, čia šito vandenį galim kažkaip gert? Nemačiau, kad čia šalia yra tas. Oh no. Ką jūs čia numetėt? Ai, tu čia numetė gerai, pala. Numetė vieną kilometro nuorodą. Aš esu įsijungsiu dabar. Kitą kilometro nuorodą. Taip, pala, tu numetėjai šitą Vilniaus. Nu, čia yra viena jūsų tas... Nu. Wait, pala. O tai kodėl tu palyginai... Pala, čia jūsų ta... Kaip rotušė čia katedra? Kaip rotušė vadinasi katedra? Kodėl tu palyginai šitą aikštę su Laisvės alėjos gatvele? Jo, dėl kad siauresnis, bet tu palyginai ne gatvę. Tipo, kaip tu gali palyginti? Tavo, rotušės aikštė, jo, tikrai Vilniui didesnė. Pas mus va rotušė tada lyginti, visa šitas tada aikštė ta. Nu, I guess jo mažesnė, bet, nu, čia belinkiek ir dvies tik mašinos pristatytos dabar. Nu, čia irgi biškai yra, I guess. Bet jeigu jau lyginti, tai jo pas mus ta didesnė, bet ar čia mes tą lyginam, kiek vietos aplink rotušė laisvos yra? Nes tada už rotušės, aš nežinau, ar čia galima nueiti. Plečia, nu, I guess visą, nu, tipo, žiūrėk seni, va rotušė ir tada pas jumis tęsiasi biškiuką, va. Nu, tas tipo, ta jūsų rotušės aištė Vilniui. Kaunas visas šitas yra, dar už jos biški vietos yra. Ir tada, jeigu už tų namų nueini, ten visas tas santakos, tas parkas. Tai čia, tai aš žinau, mes jau, ką tu norėjai palyginti, tik per rotušės, kokia yra dvira ir dvira, tai jo, Kauno mažiau yra, taip. Bet tada Kauno visa laisvė, jeigu lyginsi, Vilniui iš šito išeini ir siauros gatvelės, tipo, praėjimai tarp namų siauri, nardai tarp mažų tokių praėjimų, kurie labai ir tada, nu, vat, per visas vat, tas vat, gatvelės, kur įeini ir ten jau kremt visiškai, kas Kaune, kaip paskui yra daugiau tada tos vietos, nes aš nežinau, ką mes čia lyginam, tipo. Aš nežinau, kaip galima lyginti Kauną ir Vilnių ir apie kremt labiau. Bet jo, tu kai numetei linkus iš skirtingų vietų, bet jo, sakau, kad Rotušės čia yra daugiau vietos, aš jo, čia nežinau, tiksliai reiktų matuoti turbūt, bet čia tikrai daugiau vietos yra, bet ar mes tik tą ir lyginam, I guess? Jeigu taip, tai ne. Bet ne, jeigu tu neskaitum kremt vien dėl to, kad... Nes aš sakyčiau, vat, kai pradedi vaikščiot po tą senamestį, tipo, kai pradedi vaikščiot po senamestį, man atrodo, Kaunas mažiau kremt. Tie visi, nes vien ta laisvė, jeigu eisim pagrindinę, vat nežinau, su kuo čia reiktų lyginti. Įsukiai visokius o tokius bromus, nu čia gal ne bromas buvo, į bromus įsukiai ir panašiai. Sakyčiau, daug mažiau kremt negu Vilniaus senamestį, kai einu, tai grinai, labai siauros gatvelės tarp tų namų, ten tai tikrai suspausta yra. Bre, gal ir panašiai dabar, kai galvoju. Tokią gatvelę. Pavyzdžiui, vat, kai išlaisvės Kaune, įsukį vat, į tokią random gatvelę. Čia yra daugiau vietos, vidutiniškai, negu Vilniui. Eisi tarsi senamestį vaikščiasi ir įsuksi vat, į gatvelę. Va čia yra iliustracija, ką aš turėjau minį gal, tipo, bet aš nežinau, ar čia normaliai vertint. Pavyzdžiui, jeigu ši čia eini, vat, šita vat, ne, ir įsukį vat, ta, čia yra kremt. Čia vienas žmogus ant šalia gatvių vos telpa, jeigu tavo mama, tai iš vis netelpa į visą įeitį. Kaune kita vertus, tu įsukį, praškai visur, du žmonės ant šalia gatvių tilps, daugiau vietos, mažiau kremt. Aš apie tai gal labiau kalbu. Ir Vilniuje susidarė man toks jausmas, kad jeigu tu vat, įeisi ir vaikščiosi Vilniui, bus labiau kremt šitos vietos, nes tu daugiau tom turėsi praeiti. Kaune ne, bet aš nežinau čia, ar net galima taip vertinti. I don't know. Aš gal tą turėjau labiau omenybę ten, gerai žiūrim toliau.
Hell yes! I would like to...
Drinking fountain.
I need to fix it. Okay, guys, I wanted to do a funny gag. Last time we were here, this fucking water fountain was shooting water like this up in the air. And I wanted to just to do like a funny gag where I would splash my face with water and pretend like I didn't know for YouTube. However, they fucking fixed the thing. Don't fix the thing before I film you guys, okay? Official message to Portuguese water fountain technicians.
Toma. What?
Hey, come on guys, that's just what Europe does to a man. I can't help myself. I cannot help myself. Yes, I mean, check it out guys, it's beautiful. Supposedly this entire area was built for Expo 98, and they usually, you know, go crazy, supposedly, every country for Expo, and this is what they built here. Created by Russians, by the way. Ever hear of Mendeleev? I told you guys that we're gonna be going up on the cable
car. Tai pala. Kai manęs klausė, ką Rusija išradė, ar ta cheminių elementų lentelė, aš esu girdėjęs Mendelejevo lentelė, ar jinai čia vadinasi ta periodinė elementų lentelė, ar jinai taip ir vadinas? Mendelejevo lentelė? Periodic table. Galima Wikipedia'os rasti? Rašo čia ką nors apie jį. The first periodic table to become generally acceptable was that of the Russian chemist Dmitry Mendeleev in 1869. He formulated the periodic law as a dependence of chemical properties on atomic mass. As not all elements were then known, there were gaps in his periodic table. Nes ir predictionus darė, okay. A recognizably modern form of the table was reached in 1945 when Seaborg's discovery of the actinides... Okay, how geras. Esu girdėjęs, man atrodo, bet viskai nebūčiau pasakęs.
Created by Russians, by the way. Ever hear of Mendeleev? I told you.
Mokyklą lankė ir homeschooled. O tu inbred, blėt, ar ne? What the fuck?
guys, that we're gonna be going up on the cable car. And actually, here it is. We're almost there. I think it's like 9 euros or something to go back and forth here on this cable car. So yes, guys, I'm gonna be spending crazy money on this video. Please donate. But yeah, let's go in and get a better view of the entire area from up.
Nice parkas, tipo. Va, žalia, medis vienas ir.
Up above and talk about my lovely time in Lisbon.
Vinukai.
Russia. Is it just for statistics or why do you usually ask? Yeah? Okay, interesting. I see. Okay, thank you. You too. Oh, yeah. You too. Have a good day. She says have a good trip, I said you too. Classic. Classic social awkwardness moment, but I guess I save it. Anyway, 37.
That's a number.
Let's hope that this cable car is Damn. Going to be able to handle my astonishing new girth, because I've gotten fattest shit here in Lisbon. Another thing that I wanted to mention, food is great here. European cheeses and meats and all that stuff. You know, I want to make a sandwich with all types of prosciuttos or whatever they have. You know, I want to try everything. You guys know I want to go to Taco Bell. It's over. I'm a complete fat ass. I've been drinking Guaraná fucking daily. It's over. Like, I'm so fat right now. Gaining weight is something that a lot of immigrants go through. I already kind of talked about this previously, and you know, I'm trying to work on it. I'm trying to.
Ar matė, kad esi demiko, esi tu laidoj. Kas tas demiko?
Work on it, but fingers crossed that we do not fall.
Et jo mačiau.
In the water. Yes, guys, check it out. Here we are going over the River of Teju here. If you look that way, actually, you can see right there, that is the Vasco da Gama Bridge, which is the longest bridge, I think, in all of Europe after the... I think this bridge, unironically, was beat by only the Crimea Bridge in its length. So, but that's not something I will claim, guys. That's not an achievement of Russia that I'll be proud of. I was just speaking about food, right? So,
Esi jau aš per paskutinę savaitę visai daug shoutoutų gavau, ne? Ar per paskutinės dvi savaitės, nu, tarkim, jau paskutinės tris savaitės. Gerai, imam paskutinį mėnesį. Nes, nu, aš streaminu, kiek jau, 2 metai tą politiką, man atrodo, nežinau kiek. Jau per paskutinį mėnesį buvo labai daug shoutoutų. Jo.
Hello, hello.
Ai, labas, neduos man dažėti video, ne?
Ne, neduos.
That's not an achievement of Russia that I'll be proud of. I was just speaking about food, right? So another reason why I eat a lot of food here in Lisbon, quite honestly, is also because the amount of like different cultures here, and there's many different immigrants here from many different countries. So for example, one thing I really enjoy is actually Asian food in Lisbon is really good. Like there's so many ramen places, and I'm a big fan of ramen, so...
Kaip čia suprast? Na, čia skirtingi maistai, kuriuos tu turi čia pasikept tada? Kas čia? Ar čia tu gali valgyti iš tų indelių, nes čia atrodo kaip žalias, žalia mėsa. Bet čia tu actually pasėdi ir pasikepi. Na, tada padažai. Nu, ble, iš tikro, čia atrodo kaip iš tikro very nice tokį. Ragauji viską, sėdi, ėdi, actually pretty cool, ne? Skirtingos mėsos. Damn. Korean thing?
Because when you live in Russia, for example, you do get many food from people from ex-Soviet countries, but when it comes...
Oh, damn, iš tikro, čia viskas atrodo labai gerai.
Because when you live in Russia, for example, you do get many food from people from ex-Soviet countries, but...
Iš tikro, yra lausinai be geriau, bet iš tikro, atrodo viskas žiauriai gerai, eina savo. Varum. Varum į Portugaliją, aš noriu šitą.
When it comes to, like, Japanese...
Yra vienas mano, gerai, vienas mano toks, kai čia, priekaištas, nežinau... Lietuvoj bariukose visokiuose, jeigu nueini, ir, pažiūrėjau, alugeri. Yra snacksai prie laus, bet jie yra žiauriai tragiški, galiu pasakyti. Kai kur yra kepta duona ir kai kur jinai yra skani. Ok, good. Bet tada, kai kur yra sūriai, aš sūrių nelabai mėgstu, kas sako, tinka prie laus, bet o man nelabai, tipo, kažkaip ne. Aš ko labiausiai norėčiau, tai actually tokių, nu, mėsiško kažko. Kas yra kai kur mėsos rinkiniai, pavyzdžiui, bet labai mažai vietų ir jie yra tragiški tiesiog, actually tragiški. Čia atrodo kaip visai nieko užkanda prie alaus iš tikro. Skirtingos mėsos, daržovės, taip, jo, čia toks kaip maistas kaip ir, bet man čia skaitos kaip užkanda prie alaus būtų visai nieko. Vadybo, aš nežinau, Lietuvoje ten mėsos rinkinį pasiėmė, jis actually yra tragiškas. Kažkokia neaiškiai, nežinau, kas ten, blėt, būna, ten... Arba kitur, blėt, tam boškiai pas mus... kažkaip kaip tie gurkai su kažkuo, kažkas tokio, kas, what the fuck is that shit? Panieks ten nėra prie alaus, nežinau, nesąmonė. Jo, žodžiu, gerai, sorry, rantas.
So many ramen places.
Užkanda prie alaus turi būti mėsiška dažniau, gerai, mano pointas.
And I'm a big fan of ramen, so because when you live in Russia, for example, you do get many food from people from ex-Soviet countries, but when it comes to like Japanese or whatever, Chinese, it probably will not be as authentic or whatever. There are exceptions, but here though, it's great. You know, I mean, it's great. It's great. Every single day, essentially, you know, when I'm seeing this kind of stuff, it feels weird. It feels like I'm on a vacation. Every single day when you go outside, you see so much beautiful shit. It's really quite weird as somebody who grew up in Chelyabinsk, okay? So I really don't know how to feel about it, quite honestly. And yes, it's beautiful, but that does not mean that it's not a struggle to be an immigrant. It definitely is. And, you know, there's definitely a lot of work that goes into this stuff, just adapting to everything and trying to build a new social circle for yourself. Because essentially, when you become an immigrant, you're starting your life anew. And it's really weird, but I'm at least really happy that, you know, this is the place where I get to do that. Because this is a place that just feels really welcoming, and I love it. Что такое там? Это какая-то женщина, типа? That's pretty cool. You see those little, like, statues of... what is that? Statues of naked women with their feet up? Are they supposed to be women? Maybe I'm just a horn dog. Maybe I'm just so horny that I'm looking at like wooden sculptures and I'm thinking that it's naked women. Yes, I'm gonna have to blur that out for YouTube. However, guys, of course, living in European Union so far...
Pala, ar jie čia filmuoja moteris?
I'm gonna have to blur that out for sculptures and I'm thinking that it's naked women.
Jo, jie filmuoja moteris. Ką iš apie saprotą?
Yes, I'm gonna have to blur that out for YouTube. However, guys, of course, living in European Union so far is not without its faults for me. I mean, first of all, I recently had a really big bar moment happen to me, essentially, where I went in to pay for my electricity and I couldn't do that because the place that I went to pay for my electricity, had a strike going. I usually go in here in this place to pay for my utilities and stuff because...
Palauk, ką tu čia man atsiunti? Čia ta korejietiška barbekiu atsiunti čia taip? Ar čia ta... tas gogigai? Ai, čia šitas. Oh, wow. Nu, okay, čia skirtingos mėsos. Jesus, čia jau biškai gerai. Čia net neprilaušit su visą vakarienį jau. Damn. Aš net nesidoju, kokia čia mėsa, bet... atrodo kaip visai cool, ne? Nuvaryti bazarinį su draugai, žinai, ir dar valgyti tokį. Atrodo visai cool, šiaip.
Because I don't yet have a Portuguese bank account.
Okay.
You can only pay online with a Portuguese card, right? So I go in here in person to pay for my electricity or whatever. So today I went in to pay for my electricity. It's the deadline, actually. And I walk in and it turns out that it's closed because of a strike. So I cannot pay for my electricity in my power right now. I do not know when the strike is going to end, when it started, and why it's happening. Yes, guys.
Negalėtum pykti ant virėjo, kad neskaniai pasikeipė. True.
What is this if not a certified EU moment? Going to pay for your electricity and the place is closed because of a strike. Yes, guys, you're welcome to...
Palau, rimtai, o palau, ten yra kokia instrukcija ar kieno paklausti, kiek kokią mėsą ten reikia fucking kept ant to? Nes jeigu tu nežinai, paskui pužalę suvalgysi ir ten užsinodys, apsinodys, actually. Nebus taip, ar yra kieno paklausti? Instrukcijos man reikia. Man reikia instrukcijos tokioje vietoje, gerai. Aš kaip Vokietijoje prisimenu, gyvenau tos kelis mėnesius ir pirmą kartą mėginau pirkti vištieną Vokietijos parduotuvėje ir tada ją keptis. Ir aš nežinau, kiek laiko reikia keptis ją. Ir tiesiog pirmą kartą, kai pasikepiau ją, jinai buvo sausiausia ir turbūt neskaniausia vištiena, kokią gyvenime esu valgis. Nes, nu, aš perkepiu ją tiesiog, I don't fucking know, kiek ją kept reikėjo. Dar ten švietimas iš tikro virtuvėje pas mus buvo gan prastas, tai tipo, ar jau čia parudavo, ar ne, tipo, nu, ar ką, tai ten nieko nesimato, žodžiu, aš prisimenu tą visą gyvenimą prisimins. Normaliuose restuose tau gali ir pakepti, padavėjai labai informatyvų to klausimą, jį paklausi, bet šiaip, kai buvo patys kepimės, visualiai nesunku atrodyti atskirt, šiaip true jaučiu.
I'm insane how Russia is better. So yes, you know, guys, it's a bit inconvenient. It's a bit inconvenient that people here have human rights and people can exercise their democracy. It's a little inconvenient for me. I'm used to good old Russia where everybody, you know, works like a slave and has like such a thing as a strike is basically not existent in Russia. So I do find it interesting. But yeah, that's just the a certified European moment right there. And the reason, once again, why I wasn't able to just pay for my electricity online is because I don't have a Portuguese bank card yet. So essentially everything here in Portugal that has to do with online payments, you gotta have a Portuguese card. And the reason why I don't have a Portuguese card yet is because I don't yet have a European residency, actually, because I'm here kind of right now in a bit of a limbo, because Portugal is already known as a country that has like very slow bureaucracy and stuff. And I was aware of that when I was coming here, and you know, I knew that I was gonna have to be very patient. But also what's happening right now, actually, is that the Portuguese immigration services, it used to be called SEF, now it's called AIMA. Essentially what's happened is that they're repurposing and they're changing the entire immigration system or whatever, the entire immigration apparatus. So currently, the things that took a long time take an even longer time. So, yeah, it's a bit of a pain in the ass. And we have a ride, by the way. Let's go outside and I'll continue my story. And by the way, this right here, I think is supposed to be the tallest building in all of Lisbon slash all of Portugal, I guess, obviously.
Pala, pretty cool, pala. You know. Lisabonas, Portugalijos sostinė, jo? Jo, sostinė, jo, sostinė.
Got that big, beautiful.
Ar tikrai? Portugal capital. Jo, 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 okay.
Full Portuguese flag on top, which I love, and it actually a lot reminds me a lot of the that one building in Dubai, if you know what I'm talking about. So yes, as I was saying, the entire immigration system currently here in Portugal is essentially being reformed, and I'm, you know, I'm just the most luckiest guy ever. Of course, I had to come in and apply for my residency right at that time, so I'm enjoying my freedom here. You know, I'm free to move around.
Atrodo tvarkinga, atrodo gražiai, kur išeina ir panašiai, bet nu, aš nenoriu, žinai, susidaryti tokį, žinai, įspūdžio, kad čia visur, nes čia sostinė, sostinė, dažniausiai visur tai bus, išskyrus Vilnius turbūt. Ne, bet ypač dar ne, nu, ne pagrindiniai gatvėje, o nu, paėjus ten, kur aišku sutvarkyta, tipo, jo. Įdomu šiaip, kaip Portugalija ferina. Pas mus šiaip, kur be nuvažiuos, yra gan tvarkinga, išskyrus gal koks rajonas ar labai senas, bet ten ir mažesni miesteliai, viskas sutvarkyta. Ten nuvarai ir actually tvarkinga. Bet jaučiu čia dabar visur plus minus.
Or whatever, I'm free to live, but also I do have some restricted rights, kind of. Well, not really, it's just minor things, like once again getting to pay with your bank card for like utilities, electricity and stuff like that. You also have to pay online with a Portuguese card, which I don't yet have, because essentially you need to have your residency to open a bank account here. But by far the most annoying thing I would say is that you actually can't even download like an app for like your mobile operator, because it's in the Portuguese app store. And in order to switch to the Portuguese app store, you have to input data of a Portuguese bank card into Apple. I mean, whatever, guys. This is just iPhone user problems. We all know that iPhone users are fucking idiots anyway, so... Guess my fault, true, which is an iPhone, and, you know, betraying the Slavic Android gang. Because I literally can't download it from the Georgian store, which I'm on right now. So, being an immigrant is a fucking pain in the ass. I do not recommend it. Anyway, another big thing that I also have to talk about is the prices overall and the cost of living and everything. So far, what I think of it and if I think living here is even possible. Because here's the thing, I had a bit of a Eastern European imposter syndrome before coming here, if that makes a lot of sense. And I still have it, by the way. And I came up with that, you know, term myself. What Eastern European imposter syndrome is to me is that essentially I come from a part of the world where people are used to a way lower, not only just quality of living, right, but also way lower cost of living too. And removing yourself sort of from that bubble of post-Soviet, you know, failed states essentially, right? And to push yourself in this type of situation, it was really weird for me. Like, when I was coming here, essentially, I didn't even know if I was really going to afford living here, kind of. But I guess it's fine. Currently, it's working out for me. Rent is one of those things that is going to be a huge thing in Lisbon, because Lisbon is currently, according to many, many stats, it's either like the most expensive...
Bet čia toks RNG dalykas, kur švaru, kur ne. Atrodo, senosiose sostinėse turi būti švaru. Meanwhile, Italija baisi, Paryžius smirdit, Budapeštas me. Meanwhile, North... švariau, Vokietijoje švariai, dunau. Bet tai čia nieko random, ten kur smildi, nes ten imigrantų daug, taipgi sakė Sinica, ar kas ten, nežinau.
expensive place in Europe to rent, or like one of the most expensive places in Europe to rent, even worse than Berlin and whatever. So that's not great. So yes, rent is definitely eating away at people's pockets the most here. When it comes to like prices of foods and restaurants going out or whatever, I found that it really differs. There's so many places here. You get the tourist trap places, you get the hole-in-the-wall local places. You just gotta really go out there and experiment and find the good places, right? Obviously, since, you know, I've been only here for 3 months and I'm here kind of a newbie, I don't know anything. I've obviously been, you know, to some scammy places here and there. But, you know, it's a learning experience as well, right? Right, guys? That's how I'm coping with
being scammed. Yeah, that was a karalystės Rusy through.
But when it comes to like prices of groceries, I'd say it's obviously more expensive than Russia. That is definitely true. I'm not going to beat around the bush. But I don't even know if that's fair to compare.
Man atrodo, aš nežinau, yra koks indeksas, bet true, man atrodo, Lietuva iš tikro yra, nu, švari šalis. Ir aš kalbu, jeigu imsim overall visą, ne tik sostinę, ne tik, man atrodo, viską, nes, nu, blin, aš nebūnu dažnai ten regione kokiam, bet nuvarai kokį mažesnį miestelį. Arba kai žiūrėjom tą Japonijos Kotaro, ir kur, nu, jis varo po mažesnius miestus, nu visur rimtai švaru yra. Ir tiesiog mažai žmonių, nu tipo nežinau, ar ta atmaskė veiktų. Nu jo, nežinau. Izabono taip pat baisė situacija su imigrantais, tam pačiam centri keli metrai šoną ir afrikiečių gėtų. Nu aš aišku, jokavau dėl imigrantų.
I didn't even know if the economy doesn't make any sense to me anymore, you know? I feel like everybody around the entirety of the world just fucking hates the economy right now. Everybody thinks we're going towards, you know, the fucking end of times or whatever. So it can be definitely a struggle for people to survive here too. Hold on, I want to get down to the beach here for a little bit, but what else is there? Bills, obviously, like electricity or whatever, that stuff. Sorry guys, just almost died, but that's fine. What was I talking about? Oh yes, electricity bills and whatever, water. Yes, it's pricey and I have kind of a big apartment, so... Видите, что это такое, ваша цивилизация? Все обкакано. Yes, the bills are higher than any bills I've ever paid in my life, but... I don't fucking know, guys. I guess that's what it is. I've made the decision to side with the decaying West, and here I am. And I don't know. I'm not really here to complain about prices, to be honest, because I know how it looks. And I understand that people here that are locals, who also, a lot of them don't make a ton of money, they probably wouldn't like to hear an expat in Portugal complain about the prices. But I'm complaining from the point of view of a poor Eastern European, you know what I'm saying? It's a bit of a different thing. But living is fucking expensive these days everywhere. I really don't feel like I've made the wrong decision, basically. By coming here, because I would have had to pay a fuck ton of money for bullshit anyway. I just spent like 15k to even move here in the first place because my entire moving process was insanely difficult. I have a whole video about that, by the way. So I just guess what I have to do is I have to cherish it, and I have to cherish every single day and every single time we get the sun, every single time we get to go to the beach like this. I can't exactly say that I've been going out a lot recently, you know. I do spend a bunch of time just depressed in my room once again, but gotta get out there, guys. It's white boy summer. Gotta make this money. Gotta tell you guys the truth. And this spot, by the way, I like this spot right here because it actually reminds me a lot of Russia in a weird sense, because this place reminds me a lot of St. Petersburg. We have the Gulf of Finland. We have some places in St. Petersburg where you can actually go and see the Gulf of Finland. And here we are, guys. Right here, you know, welcome to SPB, the Gulf of Finland. We have the fucking Western Speed Diameter, the route that goes all around St. Petersburg. Like, it's also a huge bridge, basically. And this is the skyscraper, Lachta Center. So, yes, guys, okay. I feel at home. I hope you did enjoy this little walk with me around Lisbon, yeah, around the area of Park of Nations. I definitely have great first impressions of Lisbon. And
yeah, viskas reklamos, gerai. Įdomus tokia video. Šiaip jis dažnai video kelia, nes ilgą laiką nežiūrėjom. Man atrodo, ne taip dažnai. Ai, ką žinau. Ai, va, kaip tik šiandien. Biden is just the American Boris Yeltsin. Va, ir naujas, galės rytoj pažiūrėti. A ne, jis kelia viskas, kelia, tai nu, aš jau kažkaip praleidau. I guess. Ir peržiūrėjau normaliai, nu, tipo, jo, jis iš YouTube'o tikrai gyvens. Gerai, žiūrim toliau.
Koks vakaras ilgas, kaip širdį man gerai.